Tonight, I would like to discuss a very simple subject. I think it is useful for all of us and easy to remember also. This particular simple discourse of the Buddha is called Tamo Tama Parayana Sutra. There are only four lines. It is in Anguttara Nikaya, Sutra Pitaka, Chapter 4. Tamo Tama Parayana, Tamo Jyoti Parayana. Jyoti Tama Parayana, Jyoti Jyoti Parayana. Four lines. Two words, Tama and Jyoti. What is Tama? Tama or Tamas? Tamas in Sanskrit, Pali, Tama. Tama means darkness. Jyoti, there's a Chinese word also, isn't it? Jyoti. What does it mean? Jyoti. There must be a meaning. We have few members also, they are named Jyoti. You don't know the meaning. Jyoti in the Pali language, brightness. So, only two words here. Darkness and brightness. So, the name of the sutra is Tamo Tama Parayana, darkness to darkness. So, the whole mankind, you can divide into four groups. All over the world. One group goes from darkness to darkness. Another group from darkness to brightness. Another group from brightness to darkness. And the other group from brightness to brightness. Easy to remember, isn't it? Now, can you repeat? First group, darkness to darkness. Second group, brightness. Third one, darkness. Last one, brightness. Now what does it mean? Meaning is very simple. Darkness to darkness. All those who are leading, very miserable, unfortunate, unsatisfied life. By facing so many problems and worries and difficulties, sicknesses and shortcomings, these groups are in the dark. They are leading a very unfortunate life. There is no brightness in their life. Almost every day they are grumbling and worrying and crying and lamenting and accusing, complaining. No happiness, because they have problems. Then, we must find out why they had to lead such a miserable life while others are enjoying. People have not realized the real answer for this question. They have their own way of interpretation. Well, some people say, what to do? God has created us to suffer. Then why does He create some others to enjoy? Is there any reason for that? Therefore, we cannot accept this. One group to enjoy and another group to suffer. Some others believe due to bad luck. But they do not know the meaning of bad luck. Who created this? So when they cannot understand that who created this bad luck, then they refer to charm or black magic, devil, ghost. Now you are scared of your hungry ghost. You believe that bad luck come to you if you do not offer something to them. That is your belief. But there are many others who never offer anything to them, but they are okay. These hungry ghosts never go and disturb them. They always come and disturb who offer, because next year they will come and disturb more. The more you give, the more they come and disturb you. They do not know the reason why. That is why it is necessary for us to learn and to think. Kamma vipaka vattanti vipako kamma sambhav. Tasma punabhavo hoti evang loko pavati. Now this is the sayings of the Buddha in Sangyutta Nikaya, also Sutra Pitaka. Kamma vipaka vattanti. Karma creates vipaka. What is karma? Wholesome, unwholesome. In simple language, good and bad. Good and bad action create vipaka. What is vipaka? Effect. Good result, good effect, or bad effect. Kamma vipaka vattan. It is natural. There is no religion for this. So this karma is not belong to Buddhists or Hindus or few others. It is a natural or a common occurrence happening to every human being, some other living beings also. Otherwise, no one can live. So every minute we create either good karma or bad karma. Otherwise, we cannot live. There are three channels that generate this karma. Mental, verbal, physical. Our thoughts that we create in our mind also create karma, good karma and bad karma. We cannot stop thinking. After thinking, we talk something. Through these words, in four ways, we create either good karma or bad karma. We cannot keep quiet without talk. Then, when such thoughts appear in our mind, we cannot keep quiet. The mental energy, mental vibration, the volition, persuade our physical body to do something. So by using our physical body, we create either good karma or bad karma. Now these are the three channels. Kamma vipaka vattan. Whether we have a religion or not, whether we believe this or not, every human being is doing this. Otherwise, no one can survive. Vipako kamma sambhav. The effect that we have created through our own karma. Again, encourage or influence us to create either good karma or bad karma. Our own karma, which created some effect. These effects again influence us to create fresh karma. So there is no end. That is why it goes back. Wheel. How come? Assume someone is being born in a very, very miserable family, poor family, who suffer. because of his bad karma. Now that is the effect. And this suffering create unhappiness, intolerance, jealousy, anger, greed, so many evil forces in the mind because of the bad effect of the karma. And these evil forces again influence us or that person to create more and more bad karma. Now you can understand how our own karma, which produce an effect, and that effect again influence us to commit more evil, more bad karma. Now let us take the other way. Another person is being born in a very well-to-do family, very cultured, religious-minded, very understanding, because of his own good karma. Then, because of his understanding, sympathy, he tried to share his happiness, his property, his income, his pleasure with others. Then he helped others. He released others' suffering, others' shortcoming, others' problems. Then by doing that, he created more and more fresh good karma. Now he used the good effect of his karma to generate more good karma. This is the nature of existence. Kamma vipaka vattanti vipako kamma sambhava. Vipaka, the effect, karma, again condition to karma. Tasma punabhava hoti, therefore, punabhava, becoming again and again and again, take place because of these karmic forces. Evaṁ loko pavattati, the world exists because of this. Otherwise, no world. Karma is responsible for existence, not only life, everything. Mind is responsible for everything, mental energy. When you analyze, you can understand. So, when we come to know that we are leading very unfortunate life, when you compare with others who enjoy their life, this is a good lesson for us. You have heard the sayings of the Buddha, we are the result of what we were. That means this indicates, the sufferings and problems indicate what we have committed, we have done during our previous birth. So definitely, we have done something wrong. By knowing this, we must try to train ourselves not to repeat. Although we suffer today, not to continue this suffering. After that, we can maintain some sort of containment. We can reduce our jealousy and anger and hatred. When we realize that I am suffering because of my own bad karma, so others are not responsible for my own suffering. This also the Buddha has mentioned in Dhammapada. Even your father and mother cannot create karma for you. Your children cannot create karma for you. Or husband cannot create karma for wife, individual. I'm not talking about the transference of merit, that is a different aspect. So we create our own karma according to our way of thinking. Wife cannot think for husband. Husband cannot think for wife. They have their own way of thinking. Their anger, their hatred, their kindness, their compassion, their generosity, their understanding are individual. That is how individually we create our own karma. Just like hunger or sickness. The other person cannot share.
by knowing this, without allowing to continue this suffering, in the next life, we must try to change, adjust our way of life. Otherwise, we go from darkness to darkness. After suffering here, again harboring anger, jealousy, grudge and ill will and all the evil forces and committing evil forces, evil deeds. Again, another existence takes place to suffer more. This time, or within this lifetime, this person is a human being. In the next birth, there is no guarantee whether that person can become a human being again. And then there will be more suffering. Now that is the meaning of these sayings of the Buddha. Many people go from darkness to darkness due to their ignorance. So if we suffer, if we have problems and difficulties, without hating others, without disturbing others, without committing more and more evil deeds, there are many things we have to tolerate, many things we have to understand. Then we can reduce the tensions and jealousy. After that, our next birth also cannot become a miserable one. If it is not a pleasurable one, but cannot become very miserable. Our first line.